Hey there, it's your PowerPoint bestie. In this video, I'm continuing to talk through my approach to a recent submission to the Articulate eLearning Heroes Weekly Challenge. If you've seen my other video involving the Chicago skyline, you'll notice some similarities in this video. We're still creating motion behind a cutout shape, but this time there are two important differences. The background movement is from an actual video, and we're only partially subtracting from the base shape. In addition to learning how to create the specific type of slide, this video will also address alignment and distribution, shape subtraction, and the eyedropper tool. If you've seen my other videos, you can guess how we start. Insert a rectangle and stretch it across the entirety of the slide. I'll pick a random, temporary shape fill to help me differentiate this rectangle from other shapes I'm about to add. This time, I'm also going to insert several hexagon shapes, since it reminds me of a honeycomb. I'll fold down the Shift key while I click, drag, and release to keep the original proportions. Then, I'll adjust the angle slightly based on my personal preference. I'll then duplicate this a few times so I can begin making a grid. I'll click and drag around four hexagons to select them all. I'll then use the Align tool to align center, then distribute vertically. Looks like I had them too close to one another, so I'll increase the distance between the top and bottom shape, then try again. This is closer to what I had in mind. With all four hexagons selected, I use Ctrl-C to copy and Ctrl-V to paste. I'll then reposition all four new shapes at once. At first, I'll use my cursor for this, but ultimately, I'm using my left and right arrow keys to fine-tune this how I like it. It's still on my clipboard, so I paste again, and reposition the new shapes to make a third column. Now, I'll select all 12 hexagons and reposition them to the left side of the screen. The portions hanging off the slide won't be visible, but it will add some depth to the slide. Now, I'm ready to start subtracting from the base rectangle. I'll hit Ctrl-A to select everything on the slide. But here's where this video is different. Before subtracting, I'll hold down the Ctrl key while clicking on two or three of the hexagons to deselect them. Now, I can use the Shape Format tab to click Merge Shapes, Subtract. Already, you'll notice this looks different than in the more basic video. Like before, I'll select the resulting shape and set Shape Fill to White and Shape Outline to No Outline. I'm also going to insert a video from my computer. It's something I downloaded free from Pexels. You can use any video here or even use a static image. The features I'm demoing are super flexible. I'm going to click Arrange, Send to Back. It might not matter, but just in case, I went to the Video Playback tab and selected Volume Mute. I also will set the video to start with Previous so that it plays immediately. I'll open the Animation pane and delete the Pause trigger. It's just not something we need when we use a video in this manner, and honestly, it's more likely to cause problems than fix them. We're in the home stretch. I'll use the Ctrl key to select the three remaining blue hexagons. This will let me format all three at once. From the Shape Fill menu, I'll select Eyedropper and steal a vibrant color from the video. Then I'll set the Shape Outline to No Outline. Naturally, you'll want to add some information to the slide. Insert a text box into the margin to avoid embedding it in the white shape. I'll type a heading, change the font, increase the size, and reposition it on the slide. Then, I'll duplicate this, resize it a bit, and remove the bold formatting. For this demo, I'll paste in some lorem ipsum text I grabbed earlier from an online generator. I'll resize the text box, reduce the font size, and reposition both text boxes to clean up the spacing. Last but not least, for the finishing touch, I'll select the heading text, then open the font color menu and select Eyedropper. I could have used the recent colors palette, but in case you forget, you can always redo your eyedropper with one of your solid shapes and it should match. That's it. Preview your slide to see your work in action. Depending on how you use the slide, you might need to trim the video shorter or set it to loop until stopped. Let me know in the comments if that's something you'd like to see in a future video. If you found this video helpful, please like and subscribe, and check out additional PowerPoint tutorials on my channel.